Hello everyone, let's do an example on FEMAP. We're going to take a look at this problem right here, where we're going to have a 2 meter long element with between two nodes and a 1000 newton force applied at one of its ends. We have some material properties given right here that we're going to have to enter. So there you go, let's get started. We're going to work on an orphan mesh. That means that we do not have a parent geometry, so we don't have some kind of solid that we're gonna mesh and then apply our analysis to it. Like for example, when we had this is a solid. If we would mesh it and analyze that, then this is the parent geometry of that mesh. We don't have a parent geometry here, so we're gonna create the mesh right away. So let's start by entering our properties. So we're gonna go to model, material properties. There you go. Let's see, I'm gonna call it my material. There you have it. Material type, you can leave it an isotropic. And then let's see, Young's modulus was given, E was 70E9, and I believe what else was going on. There you go. Nu is 0.33. Nu Poisson's ratio 0.33. There you go. And that's all the properties we're gonna enter here. Let's see. Okay. So cancel. We don't want to enter another one. Now let's go ahead and property of the element that we're gonna be working with here. I'm gonna set it up. Our element, we're gonna create it with a rod. So I'm gonna call it my rod. Go here to element and property type. See, we have several available. We have even plate and other ones. But last video we worked with the DOF spring. We're not gonna use that. We're gonna use this one, rod. Alright, okay. Make sure you pick the material. It'll list all the materials that we have set up. We only have set up one, so there you go. That's the only one. And right here, we have an area given. Where is it? There you go. 2E negative 3. So let's enter that 2E negative 3. And that's all we have to enter for this. There you go. Cancel. That was the only material. Now we're ready to create our nodes. There you go. Let's leave our first node at 0, 0. Okay, the second one I'm going to create it along the x-axis, so I'm going to put at point x, I'm going to put 2. There you go. Cancel. Those are both of our nodes. Let's see, Control Q then brings up the visibility menu. And I want to visualize my nodes and elements. Okay, done. That was by Control Q, but also you can bring it out right here. Control visibility, right? Okay, here you go. Here's my two nodes. Let's set up our element between them. Where is it? Element, there you go. Property, the one we just set up, right? My rod, make sure you get that one. And in this, when you use the rod type of elements, it does not matter what direction you use. 1 to 2, 2 to 1, okay, the results will be correct. Remember, that's not the same story when you're working with the DOF spring. So we're gonna pick number 1. Come on, okay. Oh, you have to click into the field that it needs to fill out. There you go, 2. It's gonna be this one. Okay. And that would do it, so cancel. There you go. There's our rod with the two nodes. Now let's apply some boundary conditions, constraint. We're gonna apply it to the nodes, and it's gonna be boundary conditions. Okay, to node 1. Okay, we're gonna put a and call it left, and we're gonna put a pin right here. 1. That means no translation. We're gonna pick the other node, click OK, and here we're gonna allow it to move in the X direction, right? So that means we need to zero out TY and TZ. I'm gonna put this one as the right. Okay, and cancel that. We only have two nodes, so two boundary conditions for these. Let's see, load, nodal load, right? We're gonna, let's see, what is it, external force, external force. Okay, we're gonna apply it to which one? We're gonna apply it to this guy right here. Okay, let's see, F, we're gonna apply just a simple force here. What did they say? They wanted 1000 newtons. Okay, so we're gonna put 100, there you go, 1000. That's it. And we don't have another force to be applied, to cancel it out. There you go, that's it. Everything is entered for our simple rod problem. We can go ahead and where is it? Analyze. New, call it panel 1. Make sure you're here. 1 static. There are several other analysis types. We're working with 1. Okay, number 1. The static one, okay, and we can go ahead and click analyze right here. Wait for it to do its thing. Let's see, complete. There you go, complete. No errors. That means we successfully solved it without any issues. Now let's go and post process it. Look at these buttons right here, up here. See? This one is undeformed, so basically the way it was originally, right? This one, if you click on it, it shows how much it changed. So undeformed, deformed. You can see the change. On the third one, you can click on it and it kind of just goes back and forth between the two. It visualizes the difference. Okay, and then let's go ahead and click view, select. Where is it? Deform, beam diagram. Okay, go down here and let's see, on here on the contour we're gonna rod axial stress. Let's visualize the stress. Okay, click OK. We can click OK and there you have it. This is the stress in our rod. All right, there you have it, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Here's our little animation of our rod being extended. Hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure you like and subscribe and tune in for the next one. Have a great day.